Tonight's edition of Arizona Technology and Innovation looks at Remora, a prototype tracking device that's about the size of a car key and provides real-time GPS tracking through a cell phone. Here with more is Remora Tracking co-founder Sean McManus and CEO and co-founder Nicole Zeno. Good to have you both here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
What is Remora?
Well, Remora is as you said, a key-size GPS tracking device, and it's something that has built-in cellular. So it makes it different than everything else that's out there right now. Everything that's out there uses and relies on Bluetooth, but you're limited in range to about 30 to 100 feet. The difference with Remora is that it has cellular built into it. So think of it as a really tiny cell phone that you're able to attach to your dog, your child, an athlete running a marathon, and you're able to live track that person without any limitations.
That's interesting. I didn't realize that most of these things dealt with Bluetooth.
Yeah, absolutely. Most of the stuff on the market, including Tile, they use Bluetooth, which means you have to be connected to a phone. And that limits your range. You know, I can find my dog within 30 feet of me, but that's when he goes outside of that realm, is when I need him, and I can't strap
right.
a cell phone to him. So that's why we developed this.
Okay, now we got some photos here of the actual device and how it's applied and everything. I would imagine everything from emergency alerts to finding folks, to finding dogs and cats, as you mentioned, the whole nine yards.
Yeah, we've built in a couple different algorithms. We have impact sensor. It's one of the things that separates us from other products that are on the market. So when you fall, let's say you're hiking Camelback, you happen to fall, it looks for movement. So it recognizes that accelerometer spike. So it recognizes the G-force of a fall, and then it looks for movement. If there's no movement beyond that and you've become unresponsive, it will automatically send out your location to your emergency contacts.
And there she is hiking out there on the trails and everything. And again, you others know, and you know where the heck you are.
Well, absolutely. I mean, that's the biggest thing. We hear it every week here in Arizona. A hiker goes out, becomes unresponsive or whatever the case may be, and people can't find them. And that was one thing that hit close to home for us. And that's why we built some of these safety features into it.
And there are temperature alerts in here as well?
Correct. It has a thermometer, a magnetometer, accelerometer, gyroscope. All of these features work together to try to give you the most amount of metrics. So that way the person who is tracking their child or tracking their pet knows where they're going, what direction they're heading, how fast they're going. Are they in a car? Are they walking? We wanted to give the most amount of metrics to the user so that way they could really hone in on where this person or pet is.
Yeah, and there's Fido there with his I mean, these things, this is, microchipping animals is a big deal because okay, so the dog here gets out of the yard. He's out there on the street somewhere doing whatever dogs do. You have your cell phone, and your cell phone, is it on Google Maps? How does it work?
It is. So we've set up a geofence. So another thing that we've kind of built into the software is geofencing. So geofencing allows you to create this electronic fence on a Google Map. And the second your device goes beyond that range, it alerts your phone right away. So it'll say, Fido is out. You open up your phone, and on a Google Map, you'll be able to follow your dog exactly where they're going as they run down the street.
And you can follow the dog how far? I mean, can he go to the next county? How far does he go?
He can go to China. You can literally follow him to China, and that's the great thing about it. Think of it as when you open your phone and you're on your navigation and you see where you're going, it's the same thing. I can open my phone, I can log onto the computer, and I can see where he is anywhere in the country.
But you got to have a phone. I mean, is it this is
no.
no. You don't have to have a phone.
So Fido doesn't have to have a phone.
No, but you just
have to have a phone. I can log on to we have a web app. We have a web application you can log on to, and we also have apps that you can use on your phone. So if you're on the go, we want you to be able to track from anywhere, anytime.
And it's relatively secure unless, I guess, you want all your friends and neighbors to know where Fido is too.
Absolutely. You have control over who sees it. So you send out these links and you can revoke them at any time.
Okay. So what kind of costs are we looking at? First of all, has this been released to the public yet?
It has not. So right now we are in the crowdfunding or Kickstarter phase. We've had a great response. We've been live for about 48 hours. We've already raised $11,000 in the 48 hours. So we still have a long way to go to our $100,000 goal. And that'll be used to finish the manufacturing, get the injection molding, and really bring this product to the market. We've already secured pet rescues that we're going to be donating these devices to, just to help minimize that uncontrolled pet population that's out there. We've also partnered with local running stores, bike shops, because we really want to get this out to the community as soon as possible. But we are just finishing up our Kickstarter. It'll end, I believe, September 21st, and then hopefully come to market, release at CES in January.
Interesting. And again, this will be, can you give us a price thought of price range? Nothing you
absolutely
can't.
Yeah,
okay.
So we're looking at right now, it's going to cost about $79 for the device. That's a one-time fee. And then you're going to have about a $10 a month charge. And that basically what we wanted to do is we felt that your safety and your loved one's safety shouldn't come with an expensive price tag. So we wanted a family of four and their dog to have one for about $50 a month. And I think that's pretty reasonable to keep them safe.
So the let's just say Kickstarter campaign works. You get your $100,000. What kind of timetable? I mean, it really depends on getting that money in there, correct?
Yeah, and the one thing I want to mention is that right now, if you go back us on Kickstarter right now, it's not a donation. You are pre-buying the device, and you're getting it at a cheaper cost. Right now, you can go on our Kickstarter and get the device for $50, or for $125, you can get the device and a year subscription. And we're looking to launch it in January at CES, which means you get it before anyone else. You're gonna get it either January or February, depending on which one you pick, and you're gonna be able to get it right away.
Last question here before we go. Will these be made here?
Yes.
So the whole thing is based here and made here?
Yes, we want it made in the United States. That is a huge, pride for us, and I think it'll resonate really well with everyone here, especially in Arizona.
All right. Well, thank you both for coming in. We do appreciate it.
Thank you for having us.
Start keeping tabs on you guys if you walk around.